This video is made possible by EA Game Changers. Big thank you to EA for allowing me to participate in this event. Hello, my beautiful buddies. Welcome to an exciting video. I have early access this time around to get famous, so I am doing a review. My review is going to be split up in two different parts. I am going to be doing a video right now for Cass, reviewing the Creatism portion and what I think of that, as well as talk to you guys about the Alto family. I brought them back from The Sims 3, and I'll explain who they are too if you're not familiar with them. But I am going to also talk about build and buy and the world and gameplay and all that fun stuff in the build portion. And that will be up probably Friday. I guess that's tomorrow. No, depending on when this goes up. Or like sometime this weekend. I'm gonna try because their house is quite big. It's a mansion, so gonna try for Friday, but if not, then sometime either on this weekend or Monday, you guys will see it, and you guys will hear all of my thoughts about that. But firstly, I kind of want to talk to you guys before I tell you guys backstory and things like that. I want to tell you guys my opinions on what I think about Get Famous, at least for the Creatism portion, like I said I was. But I am really, really impressed. I really think that there is some really beautiful items, some really, really high quality, beautiful, like dresses and just full body outfits. It features a lot of like acting career like outfits, but I also feel like that you do get a lot of glamorous things too. Like it's a good split and good mix between the two. I really, really enjoy the hairs. I really think that all of the hairs are really, really usable. Because, like, I don't know about you guys, but I feel like sometimes that there's always, like, that like, few hairs, like, three of them or two of them. Like, you're like, I don't know if they're really my thing. But I really do generally feel like all of them pretty much are. The only one I feel like is a little bit extreme is the bun. The bun is, like, a little bit floppy for my taste, unless I'm, like, going for kind of a Victorian sim. But if you're going for that, that's absolutely perfect for it. That might just be like a taste for my thing. The only other thing too that I feel like should have been added was there is this great pair of jeans, but unfortunately they have like a makeup holster on them. So like if your sim isn't like a makeup artist, then like it doesn't make sense for them to wear it. But yeah, I do generally feel like I love all of the jackets. I love all of the shirts, all the pants, all of the dresses. The men get a really, really good selection as well, and they get like some like Versace looking suits, as well as like Gucci slides and like this like fancy Rolex. And even the kids like look like they have like a Gucci sweater or something like that. I was like living for it. I was like, yes, it's exactly what I think of when I think of like the whole rich and famous thing. So I really do think this is really, really good. Even for just like the Kaz part alone, if you're like a mostly Kaz person, you do get some like really beautiful items. I really think they pair nicely with city living if you have city living. And like I will definitely be using this one to hop new a lot. Like honestly, like I'm not just saying this, like I really do generally feel like that for clothes, other than city living and seasons where we got like of course like a lot of different clothes, I really do feel like this really adds a lot of like stylish too. And like I really do feel like too, like all of these clothes were like perfect for Vita, because Vita has this very like housewife, expensive housewife look to her, and like she wears a lot of furs and things like that, and there was like a lot of those in this pack. So I was like, I have to bring back the Altos. and yeah, so moving on to like who the Altos are. If you don't know who they are, or if you never played Sims 3, you might be thinking, who the heck are they? Basically, the Alto family is a family that was in the Sims 3, and they are kind of like rivals to the Landgrads. They are what I like to call new money, and land grabs are like old money, if you know what I'm talking about. Basically, land grabs like have had their wealth from generation to generation, versus these guys, they've acquired their wealth over their lifetime, and they're very, very like wanting to flaunt it. Like, they wear a lot of expensive things. As you can see, like, you know, she's wearing that, like, fancy fur dress as, like, her everyday wear. And she wore something really similar to that in the Sixth Street, too. And, like, that wasn't just me just, like, pulling it out of my hat. Like, she actually did. I'm gonna try and insert, like, a picture for you guys so you guys are able to see it. But yeah, they live in, like, a really, really fancy mansion. So, Sims Wiki, because I get a lot of my information from Sims Wiki, says their mansion is a little bit more over the top and, like, almost a little bit gaudy. So, like, I think that will be kind of fun, because, like, I do definitely think that, like, you know, like, putting that really extra gold toilet in their house will be absolutely perfect for them, just because they have a lot of those, like, really over-the-top items, and I feel like I can really go ham in their house so for when I do, like, the build, and that will be, like, super-duper fun. But yeah, basically, so Mr. Alto over here, he owns a business, he's a businessman, and while the wife, Vita, I believe she's, like, a local representative, she's in the politician career, and they're both really not great people. They're both mean, evil people. Like, even, like, Mr. Alto, like, he has, like, a aspiration for, like not mischief, like, the criminal, you know, you guys know what I'm talking about, and I feel like that, like, really contrasts their daughter, Holly. And their daughter, Holly, is, like, the opposite of them. She's a good Sim. She's also, like, a vegetarian. And she's just, like, really, really sweet. And she's kind of, you could almost, like, pass her off almost as, like, a middle-class Sim compared to her parents. Like, she doesn't flaunt it nearly as much. And, in the Sims 3, I noticed she was, like, very kind of, like, plain Jane looking. Like, she didn't really have a style one way or another. So I feel like I kind of, like, beefed her up a little bit in this version, like, gave her more of a stylish kind of look to her. And I kind of just thought, like, in my head that these Sims, more so than just the items that they wear and, like, they'll have in their house, the reason why I feel like they'd be absolutely perfect for, like, Get Famous is the story that you could tell with them. Because they have this rival with the land grabs, I think it would be fun for you to take, like, Holly and maybe have Holly move out on her own, and her starting to get into a romance with one of the land grab boys, either, like, Malcolm or Johnny Zest. Actually, I feel like Johnny Zest would be perfect. If you don't know, Johnny Zest actually was a land grab before he got disowned. You could tell the story of how he got disowned, because he wanted to be an entertainer. Like, I feel like that would be absolutely perfect with this. And yeah, I feel like I would even be interested personally on, like, just on, like, playing with them a little bit. Let me know if you guys want to see me do a little gameplay with them, because I would be totally interested. In fact, I was, like, really thinking that I kind of wanted to go ahead and maybe do a Twitch live stream over on Friday with the Sims. So if you guys are really interested in seeing that, you guys can go ahead and follow me over there and click my notification, like, heart bell thingy over there on Twitch, and you will get emails notifying you for when I'm live. Otherwise, I will tweet and tell you guys, because, like, I think that would be really fun, because I really haven't gotten a chance to play much gameplay-wise yet. I really do think that would be really fun to go ahead and, like, dive into that. I don't know if I'll do, like, a full-on LP, just because of how many things I have planned for builds for, doing a save file. Because, like, if you guys don't know, if you're coming here for the first time, I, have a save file that I'm currently working on. It has a Pleasant View from The Sims 2, and I'm currently working on Screenshot from The Sims 2, and I just, like, basically it's just, like, an ongoing project I have, and, like, now that terrain tools and all these build items are in my possession, I can go ahead and start, like, creating, like, the world of Strangetown for you guys. But, like, I really, really want to dive in, because, like, this is so new, and it's so fun, and I really, really love Fame Packs. It, like, I feel like this is, like, a good, you know, like, not predecessor, that, because that's, like, pre, but I feel like The Sims 3 Late Night was one of, honestly, my favorite packs, and I really, really do feel like that this is kind of like that in a way, but kind of not. It does feature you getting famous, I guess, more like Showtime from The Sims 3, but, like, it has its own flair to it. It is definitely has its own style to it. Like, I really, really love how the world of Del Sol Valley really, really looks. I really do really feel like it feels like LA to me. The only thing I feel like I would really, really like about it is, like, maybe if we got, like, two more lots. Like, I feel like Del Sol Valley is just a little bit too small. Or, like, even if they didn't add two more lots, because I know they said, EA said that they didn't want to add more lots just for performance-wise. I really do feel like that everyone would gain from having maybe two less lots in the, like, town square center, and, like, having two more residential lots instead, like, maybe getting rid of, like, the gym and, like, the extra lounge or something like that, or like, the art museum, or, like, whatever the extra lot is, because I have, like I said, I haven't delved too deep into it yet, but, yeah, I feel like that would be really nice, because I really do feel like that there was definitely some room off to the right side of the map that they could have added, like, a couple of more, like, medium, like, not medium, but, like, more middle class, because I really do feel like Del Sol Valley kind of goes from, like, we started from the bottom and now we're here kind of thing. Like, you know what I mean, right? Like, there's, like, the really, really expensive houses or lots at the top of the hill, versus, I feel like, more, not like, okay, like, you could build a middle class home there, but they feel like more low end, more like suburban homes. Other than that, like, I really like this pack. Like, I really, really like the way that your Sims really have to, like, work for getting famous. That was something in The Sims 3 that I feel like all of my Sims just became famous for, like, no reason. But I really do feel like that this really gives your Sims a reason and a purpose and something to work towards for being famous other than just being friends with somebody. And I really, really enjoy that you can get famous from virtually any career in the game. So if you're like, I want to be a secret agent, but I really want to be a famous secret agent, you can do that. If you want to be a famous criminal, you can be a famous criminal. You don't have to just be a famous actor or a famous social media person. You can be it with anything. And that's something too. Like, if you have City Living or the other packs and you have those careers, they can combine with this as well. So there's lots of different like things you could do with this. I'm curious to see from you guys too, if you guys are picking up this pack or not. And also too, guys, I'm sure you guys have noticed too that I have slowed down the pace at what I do my normal creative sims, just so you guys can see all the new items and things like that. I unfortunately didn't have a toddler or a child in this household, so I was unable to show you guys the items for them, but I am sure that you guys could take a look over on EA's live streams or something like that. I'm sure, like, the Sims community has, like, pictures for you guys to look at if you guys are wondering for what they have. But they also have a couple of items for the toddlers. They have, like, three different items. They're super cute. I really love the leather jacket. And the children do have items as well. My favorite, of course, is that, like, Versace, like, looking jacket for the kids. And I would love to hear, you know, your guys' thoughts on this thus far. And if you guys are willing to, like, if you guys would like to see some gameplay with these, like, it's not a promise that I do let's play, but at least me trying it out and, like, my initial thoughts and things like that. I can't wait to show you guys with the build once I get finished with it. Thank you guys also so much for supporting me. I wouldn't be able to do this without you. Please follow me on all my social media, including my blog down below. And I will see you guys later, okay? Bye, bye, bye! Thank you.